Welcome everyone to our beloved St. Eve's Parish. I'm going to take you on a virtual tour today so that you can see all of the wonderful work that's been going on in our parish over the last 100 plus years, and also to speak about some of the projects that we've done more recently and the plans for the future. And all of this is part of our introduction to you for the reasoning behind this new initiative of the St. Eve's Rose Fund, which will help to ensure our parish and all of its legacy for generations and generations to come. So come with me now as we go through our entire campus here. So here we are in front of our parish center. This is really the hub of so many of our activities. As you enter here on the ground floor, you'll find that there are three different meeting rooms besides our reception area and our gift store. Up above is where we have all of our offices, where our very competent, kind, friendly staff take care of all of the behind the scenes that makes everything else flow so beautifully. And here we have what we call our Blessed Mother Room. This is a place where we often meet with people when we're counseling them. Sometimes we meet young couples preparing for marriage, sometimes meeting with families to prepare the funeral liturgy for one of their loved ones. So it's a really intimate, beautiful space here. Now the room that we're going into right now, this is what we call the Good Shepherd Room. Back in the day, this used to be the chapel of the convent. So that's why you can see over here the beautiful stained glass window of the Sacred Heart. But this room is now used for our monthly staff meetings, our weekly bereavement meetings, our pastoral council meetings, finance council meetings, guardian ministry, you name it. This is one of the favorite places for us to meet. And in just a moment, I'm going to bring you over to the other side of the parish center, which is where our St. Francis room is. And here we are in what we call the St. Francis room. Again, one of the rooms that we renovated during the pandemic. All of the artwork on the walls here depicts something from St. Francis to really respect our Franciscan roots. It's here where our cornerstone men and women meet. You can see over here, we have a beautiful little image of St. Francis, or Pope Francis, I should say. Pope Francis over here, and it's a place where sometimes our staff will have lunch here and we'll have other different gatherings. Our Rosary Society meets here, our scripture sharing group, and again, just to give you a little bit of historical context, this used to be the refectory or the dining room of the old convent, and through those doors over there is where the old kitchen was. We still use it as a kitchen, but obviously very different from when the nuns were here all the way back in the 1950s, 60s, and 70s. Come into our courtyard. Here in the middle, you see there's a fire pit, which has been used to warm teenagers as they're praying the rosary at nighttime. Sometimes they roast marshmallows here. If you look over to this side with me, you see the beautiful mosaic of our patron saint, Elizabeth of Hungary. And then as you go around, as you follow around, you'll see that we have all of the shrubs put on there that the deer don't eat, thank God. And then you have the beautiful mosaic of St. Francis to respect our Franciscan roots. And it's here in our new courtyard that was really one of our beautification projects. Lots of people donated different parts of it. We have our tables that are our benches. We have the wonderful awnings, canopies that help us. I could probably use that right now because the sun is beating so down upon me. But yet this is another aspect of what we try to do in our parish is constantly look for ways to improve areas, to create spaces where people can pray, worship, and be with one another. This truck that you see here, the St. Elizabeth Food Ministry truck, it's used basically 6 out of 7 days out of the week as we go and collect food and bring it to needy people in Patterson and other ministries that we collaborate with. And now here we are in front of our school. As you can tell from the big blue banner that's out there, since 2011, we've been designated a Blue Ribbon School. And above it, you can see just some of the solar panels that we've put up on top of the gym, also across the flat part of the roof. That is part of our plan, which we were able to install all of that for free, but part of our plan to save money going forward, thousands and thousands of dollars through this solar power generation. This used to be the church from 1954 to 1992. Up there is the old choir loft now where the spectators sit. Here where the games are played is where everyone used to kneel facing in this direction. As you can see right now, we have it set up for a book fair for our students. There have been hundreds of basketball and volleyball games played here over the years. And I'm sure 100 years from now, the St. Elizabeth's Crusaders will be playing in the same gym that used to be a church built back almost 75 years ago. But one of the things that we're going to try to do with our St. E's Rose Fund is to get up enough financing so that we can take care of some of the internal workings. All of this stuff that you see here dates back to almost 75 years ago. Different things that have happened over the years to fix it up. But we need to do an upgrade as well to our internal mechanical systems, because as you can imagine, after all that time, they need some love and care and concern. As you all know, we have 63 different ministries here at St. E's. And I'm at the ramp that leads down to the Elizabeth Room, Music Ministry Room, Youth Room, and every day, one of these rooms is being used. On Mondays, they have the seniors' luncheon, Wednesdays, Bible class, Wednesdays, Thursdays, choir rehearsals. You have on the weekends, Cornerstones down here, our youth ministry, our light ministry. So many different things happen in these very areas underneath our church. So here we are in front of the chapel. This is something that we built during the pandemic, which I know seems like a bit of a distant memory right now. But thanks to the funding that came through the Capital Campaign, thanks to your additional generosity for the furnishings, we were able to build a sacred space that serves so many different purposes for our parish, as an overflow for Christmas and Easter, as a cry room during the weekends, as a place for daily mass. And I'm also so proud of the reconstructuring that we did of the 9/11 memorial out here. But I want to bring you inside now. One of the things that we tried really hard to do when we were constructing this back in 2020 during the pandemic was to represent all phases of our church's history. So the stained glass window that you see there is from 1902, from our first church building on the corner of Clinton and Everett. The tabernacle is from 1954, when the church was in its original place, which is now the gym. And then even the altar that's underneath here, that was actually from our 1992 church. So you have 1, 2, 3, and now we're in the fourth prayer space of our church. And all of this is obviously thanks to your great generosity. I love the stained glass window of the Rising Christ, the Sacred Heart, really beautiful artwork that was done there. But then as you see here, we have the listing of all the Capital Campaign donors from 2012, and this from the donations from 2021 when we were furnishing our chapel here. As we enter our beautiful church now, for me it's a reminder of how much work we've actually been able to do as we enter Jesus's presence here. And we think of all of the wonderful people, for example, in the choir, so many of our volunteers who make our liturgy so, so beautiful. We think of our altar servers, our lectors, our sacristans, our ushers. And if you remember, during the last few years, we had that ability to, thanks to your generosity, to take out all the pews, sand them down, re-varnish them and everything, and they look as beautiful as brand new right now. We were also able to take out the green carpet and put in the flooring here. So all those things that we did, there's going to be more things to come. There's a great gift coming to us in early December. Friends of mine from back in St. Gabriel's Day, they've donated to us a 7.5 foot long Steinway piano that we're refurbishing right now. Eventually down the road, our St. E's Rose Fund will have to be kicking into high gear, as I'm sure in probably another year or two, or maybe three, we'll have to replace our electrical organ. But this is our beautiful sanctuary. As you know, this has been the home for all of us for the last 30 years, and it will be the home for St. E's for so many more years to come, where we come to worship our Lord Jesus Christ, to receive Him in Holy Communion, and to be united with one another and what sustains us, our faith in Jesus Christ. Thank you for coming on this virtual tour with me. It's really been a joy walking around the campus, pointing out to you the things that we've been able to accomplish during these last 6 years. And as you know, Cardinal Tobin just assigned me for another 6-year term. So I'm excited for all of the other things that we'll be able to do to keep improving our parish in every aspect. And if you remember one of the early homilies I gave many years ago, I shared that little poem I learned as a child, good, better, best. Never let it rest until your good is your better and your better is your best. And so one of those things that I would like to announce to all of you, the reason really for this video, was to speak about our St. Ease Rose Fund. We're looking for parishioners, all of you who've been so generous building up this parish over these years, to make yet another step in generosity. And as you know, I never ask you to do something I'm not willing to do. I have decided that I'm going to change my own last will and testament to make St. Ease a recipient when it comes for my time to leave this world. And as you know, we come into this world with nothing, we leave this world with nothing, but what we leave to the world is our legacy. And each one of us has our own individual, our own family legacy, but it's also been entwined with our parish legacy, this wonderful, incredible parish of St. Elizabeth's that's been around since 1902 in Wyckoff, New Jersey. Your participation in the Rose Fund will help to sustain it for many, many more generations to come. So I invite you to consider joining me and dedicating that really last ultimate act of generosity to the parish and considering leaving something in our last will and testament to make sure that St. Ease continues to blossom and flourish for centuries to come. Thanks, everyone. Great to be with you. See you soon in church. God bless.